Good evening, everyone. With Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, I'm Mike Emmerich. It's Halloween, and the ghosts and gremlins are hovering near the ceiling of the old arena, watching with all of us. Eddie, your thoughts?
These two teams both need the W here tonight. I can see them playing it safe early, but the question is, which team will make the first mistake?
Parisi's out there for the start. They know he can establish their style early. Puck dropped, clock moving. Point-to-point pass from the left wing. Tape-to-tape to center. In the slot! Got that pass near the blue line and now looks ahead. Long saucer to Buffalo. No room for a pass. Out to the half wall. Big point-blank save there.
Not often you're all alone in front of the goaltender from this area of the ice. Great save.
And he's hammered.
Looks like he arrived at the rink in a bad mood. Maybe he missed his wake-up call. That early hit is an angry one.
That hit somebody. Puck skipped loose. He's knocked to a knee. Holds in the corner. Has that point pass as well. Big save there. Dubnyk's puck to play, so he does.
Let's hope that there's lots more going to happen here other than what we've seen in the first part of this game. The teams are gently prodding and trying to find an opening, but there's not much going on.
Fires. Wonderful block. Passing one off now to Little. Into the end of attack. Using the point. Shot on. Paddled aside. Hockey on Halloween is here, and down to the ice without a mask, here's Ray.
Doc, there's been some changes over the last 10 years that maybe go under the radar, but have really changed the way the game's been played. Shifts used to be a minute long. Now 30 to 40 seconds is absolute max because the game is played at such high energy and maximum effort that you can't go any longer.
Thanks very much, Ray. Puck picked up here. Fires! What a reaction save!
Seems like he was in too tight on the goaltender.
Ooh, he got in the way of that one. Hammers one! Save! Pulls his way along. Shoots! He scores! Ghouls and ghosts and goblins and gorgeous goals all a part of Halloween night.
You could really see this goal coming as a result of the pressure that they had for a long period of time. I think the players on the ice were just out of gas.
The butterflies become a default position for the goaltender, Edzo. And while the shot is nice, he's down in that butterfly position way too quickly.
A little past halfway here in the first. Minnesota's got the lead, 1-0. The Jets control from the neutral zone.
Scored by number 16.
Gets across, looks over his options. A shot. Score! Trick or treat. The trick was the score. The treat for him, his team.
Niederreiter's wrist shot was heavy and quick.
He just wasn't able to get over and cover the top of the net. The shot's perfect. It's right in the roof, and the goalie's dejected.
Winnipeg's got it off the draw at center. The Jets lug the puck through the neutral zone. Goes back deep for it.
Time of the goal, 10 minutes, 50 seconds.
Collected by Kulikov. The Jets with possession up the wing. Propelled to Little. Great stick save. Puck is thrown to Foligno. Thrown in. Gathered up by Kulikov. The Jets wheel one ahead up the wing. Turned a shot on net, and a save. Nice job holding the puck. snaps one in there. Outstanding offense met by solid goaltending. And the loose puck brought in by Myers. Solid rebound. No out of bounds in this sport.
That was a major league collision.
Freezes play.
Stewart's a large human, and when you really slow it down, you could really feel the force of this hit.
Good job on that faceoff, tying the man up. Winnipeg's moving the puck up the wing. Let's it go. He is shut right off. That shot came from just 6 inches.
You don't get many better opportunities than that. Great save.
He's in on an onside play. Winnipeg's in possession as they travel up the wing. Nearing the 20th minute of this period. Wouldn't let him by. Enormous hit.
In the first period.
Oh, broke it up. Possession taken over by Coyle. Corralled it again. Swept on to Spurgeon. The first frame is done. Now they get a rest. Minnesota struck twice. 2-0.
Willimon's Recycling is a proud sponsor of tonight's game. Willimon's Recycling recycles enough paper to save more than 41 million trees.
Niederreiter's marker made this a 2-goal lead for his team. Intermission is next. Second period about to begin here. Let's take a look back at the first. What impressed you most?
Winnipeg's lucky to still be in this game after the first period. They had turnover after turnover. I'm sure the coaches addressed that problem in the intermission.
Let's the shot fly. Just missed the net.
When the puck sounds hard when it hits the end boards, that means you've missed the net. Scoring chances handed away.
Pass attempt to Wheeler. They'll have control in their own end. Good stick work, and for that reason, it's a chance for the offense. At the point of drive. Played to the point to Byfuglien. In front. Still no shot. Hangs on to it. Back to the blue line. He had a great chance, but he has just missed the net.
You talk about a heavy, hard shot.
What a terrific save. Moving it to Parisi. Gains the zone. Let's it go, and a save. Skilled play by Eric Staal. A shot, he had the goalie beat and hit the iron.
Zucker's delivery was so quick, it looked like it was in the net from where I'm standing. I think this game is gonna be spread out, but this puck hits the post and stays away.
Shoots one, he scores! That is the best play off the wing since one made by that famous vampire.
The goal scorer put that puck in a shooting position, let it go, and beat the goaltender clean.
And so as soon as that goaltender drops down, everyone's looking at the top of the net, and the stick side was wide open.
The Jets trail by only one now, and they've had the puck a great amount of time. Just over 6 minutes have gone by in the second. Minnesota's defense gave up one just a moment ago, but they're still in the lead, directing that one to Little. Sends to the point. And at an angle to Perreault.
6 minutes, 3 seconds.
Sauced big time to Kulikov. Minnesota's recoiling back in their own end. Looking to Zucker. Gains the zone. Outstanding save made off a terrific chance. Terrific save there. Didn't look like he had anything to shoot at, and he made it tough.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area. You got to find a way to put it in the net.
Puck collected. Carries it to the corner.
I'd say this game has played out pretty much according to plan. Both teams have been really focused on the defensive side of the puck. There's not much room. It has been pretty physical, and when there are chances, the goalies have been sharp.
He scores! Ghouls and ghosts and goblins and gorgeous goals, all a part of Halloween night.
No hesitation at all. He fired home that wrist shot.
Dubnyk's presenting himself pretty largely here. However, there's still room for the puck to beat him.
The Jets have evened the game here. Still in the second period, anybody's game now. Winnipeg's won that faceoff in the neutral zone.
Assisted by number 19, Nicholas.
Let's it go. That shot hit a man.
Tyler Myers. Time of the goal. 10 minutes.
It's dumped in.
Seconds.
Trying to go to Lowry. Great stick work prevents the pass from being complete. Score!
Gave the goaltender no time to react with that quick snapshot.
Mason's thinking he's got the angle covered, and he probably's got most of it, but it hits the inside of the post and beats him.
Minnesota's pulled ahead by one. They haven't dominated in play, but they're ahead on the scoreboard.
Minnesota.
Good help for the centerman. Now it's directed to Quincy. Taken away. Using the point, he's got it. Lets it go. Great save.
Oh, the goalie was screened on that shot. You got to rely on your positioning to make that save.
A shot. What a shot. It glanced off the crossbar. No goal. Block. Stewart's got it in the defensive zone, headed to center. Mason's able to handle this one. The Jets waiting back in their own end. Puck lost, knocked to a knee. Little pass that can start some progress ahead. Snapping a pass to Bufflin. Oh, deflected away. Minnesota's organizing back in the defensive zone. It's an onside play. Slot shot. Oh, stick save. Puck covered, whistle blown.
Tough to stomach from a shooter's perspective. That was a perfect shot. The goaltender can't get to it, but you get nothing for it.
Winnipeg's got a defensive zone win. Loose puck knocked away by Eric Staal. Pitching this one to Dano. Possession still as he moves up the wing. Players tired, about to get a rest as we go late into the second period. A good stick there, so no complete pass. Shoots! Wonderful save! What a skill level there!
Terrific stop from right in front of the net, but you gotta find a way to put the puck in the net.
That's a marvelous save! Back to the blue line to Trouba. Oh, and a save! And the period comes to an end. Woo! We all need a rest now.
Fans, time for our parachute drop. If you'd like to join our Insiders Club here tonight, you can get exclusive media-only access to upcoming press conferences.
Enna's goal is the one we want to show you because it's the go-ahead goal as we head to intermission.
Insiders Club today.
At least 20 minutes to go. What are your thoughts so far?
Winnipeg's coaching staff, Doc, has to be pretty pleased the way they played through the first 40 minutes of play. One area of concern has been their offense. They need to take advantage of all the time of possession and finally put the puck into the back of the net.
Pitching it to Suter. No, that pass escaped back over the blue line, so everyone has to get back. Good use of the stick, broke that pass up. Oh, and he is drilled. Save! Puck covered, whistle blown. We have a winner. Passing one off now to Wheeler. Gets in. What'll he do? Good place to shoot from. Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a face-off right near it. Winnipeg's quick on the draw. Ripper! Wonderful save! It didn't look like he had a thing to shoot at.
Not a lot of room to score from in that area. Great save.
He takes that point pass. Gathered in by Wheeler. Muscled long to Bufflin. To the point it comes. Deflected off the blocker. Tries to clear. Recollected. Good quick poke check there. Collected at the boards. Off his pad. They score! Trick or treat. The trick was the score. The treat for him, his team, and the fans.
He's got a nose for the net, and especially scoring goals off the rebound.
Oh, the goaltender's got to do a better job of that one, Edzo. He makes that first stop, but he leaves the rebound too close to the net where the goal scorer can grab it.
Winnipeg's third period goal has tied this game, and there's still plenty of time to go. Plus, the momentum seems to have gone to them. Neutral zone faceoff one. Possession established here. Oh, and he's hammered. Great point-blank save.
With this puck being so close to net, this is all a reactionary save.
Gets in. What'll he do? Takes that pass. Missed. Nice tip of the pass. Loose puck did not go well. Receives that pass from the other side. Up to the point. Point blast. He missed the net.
Boy, this puck had a lot of steam on it, but unfortunately, he turned his hands over, and that's what caused the puck to miss the net badly.
Puck loose because of that hit. Good body contact. Good work with the stick. Puck is thrown to Perreault. Nicely into the zone. At the front of the net! Zucker's in his own end, headed toward center. The pass fails and the puck leaves the zone. Fires! Outstanding save. What magic to even get the shot away.
A quick developing play right in front. Almost looks like he
got it all.
You can't ask for a better opportunity in a scoring zone. What a great glove save. Rodin's a type of player that loves to get involved physically, and he did right in the middle of that huge collision.
Possession established. Good reach there. Minnesota's got it and moving it through the neutral zone. And he dumps it in. He's pinned and held at the boards. Taken over again. The Jets want to generate something up the wing. Mashed in. That one comes back. Goalie's allowed to handle this puck, and he does. Side to side they go, trying to generate something. Wonderful. Magnificent save. Over 5 minutes still showing on the clock this period. A hockey game is a game of lead changes. This one now is even. Minnesota's lugging it through the center ice area. Two sticks together, they cancel. And gathered in by Spurgeon. Tries to get it on net. Good job with the stick. What hung right over him and couldn't get it past.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
To Eric Staal. Solid defensive position there. Nicely received at the point. cranks one. No!
Having a heavy shot like that is great, but you got to hit the net.
He gains the zone, and he is reefed.
You want to be into a game, hit or be hit.
We are in the 60th minute out of 60. To Scheifele. Winnipeg's up the wing, controlling play now. From the outside. He's got his pad on that one. An outstanding save. Under a half minute. What control. Back to the point to Myers. Pitch to Wheeler. Back at the point now. 21 left. 19 still to go. Throws it to Myers. Pass across at the point. Sends it down low. Sends it back the other way. To the last 10. The Jets leave their own end. Perfect passing right through center. We had three periods of hockey action, and we come out flat even. And we head to overtime. Through 60 minutes, the shots on goal are 27 for Winnipeg, a lucky 13 for the Wild.
Fans, tonight, the home team bloke is dropping.
Coming up next is overtime. This is the one that has forced OT as we head to break.
14 restaurants, Delman's has it all.
We are underway in overtime. Who's the hero going to be? Terrific opportunity, but a missed pass, and so they have to drop back. Good shooting place. Just missed high. Score! And the overtime is finished. And this wacky Halloween game has come to a conclusion. It'll take a long time to write a story about this one. Maybe it was the full moon.
There's the old adage, get it to the net. You never know what can happen. Because he doesn't hit it solidly, the goalie is fooled on it.
Terrific contest. Two teams gave their very best. See you next time.